الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين The question presents itself to some Muslims. I'm not going to say all the Muslims. Is it time to shave my beard? Is it time to quit going to the mosque? Is it time for sister to take her hijab off? I want to say to you, my brothers and my sisters, no, it's not the time. And is never going to be the time. It depends how is your iman. If you're thinking about what you heard in the news by somebody, American citizen, seeking self-appointing to be a president, a person tried to find something to sell it to the American people. Whatever his intention, As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, وَمَا تُخْفِي صُدُورُهُمْ أَكْبَرُ And whatever they conceal in their hearts is greater than what they're saying. Somebody proposing that let's stop migration to America. Don't let any refugees, any Muslim, not refugees, Muslims to come to America. And those Muslims in America, when they leave, don't let them in. This is one person. It's not because every shouting we're going to jump and run. You have to have some stability in your life. Sometimes the mountains will be shaken, but you as a believer, your heart is not supposed to be shaken because you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't believe in America or Donald Trump or any of these things. You believe in Allah. You fear Allah. Your iman, your fear is only with Allah, for Allah, by Allah. This is not something new. Not with the Muslim Ummah, but for all nations and even prophets. We have to understand it's not the time to shave your beard. It's not the time to change your name from Muhammad to Mu. It's not the time for you to abandon the mosque, although some of us abandon the mosque in their own because chasing the dunya. The more you're chasing the dunya and you're forgetting about your deen, even if an ant crow or walk, you'll be scared and you'll be jumping. But if you are a believer and true believer, you be strong like the mountain and stronger than the mountain. Khabbab ibn al-Arat, may Allah be pleased with him. He said, we went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa kana mutawassidan bi'aba'a inda al-Ka'ba faqulna ya Rasulallah ala tastansiru lana? Ala tad'u Allah lana? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who's leaning against the Kaaba, resting there while he have his clothes under his head like a pillow. And Khabbab approaches the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Say, O Prophet of Allah, why you don't seek help from Allah for us? Why you don't beg Allah for victory for the Muslims? Why you don't make dua for us? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't like this. He did not answer him while he was laying down. He got up because it disturbed him to see the Sahabi saying things like this. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam immediately remind him, "Kan rajul fi man kana qablakum yu'khazu fa tuhfaru lahu al-hufra fi al-ard thumma yuda'u fiha thumma yu'ta bil minshar." فيوضع في مفرق رأسه حتى يقطع في القتين لا يصده ذلك عن سبيل الله عن دين الله. By Allah, those people before you, those believers, take the sirat and the methodology of those who before you, the believers, those who follow Jesus, those who follow Moses, those who follow all the prophets. The sunnah of Allah is the test. It's going to be a trial. It's going to be a hardship, time of difficulty, but you're going to be strong and you're going to be more eager to practice your deen. Because this is the time that everybody wants to know about Muslims. When they hear somebody talking about Muslims, boycott them, keep them out of our country. They are nothing except such and such. He said, the believer among nations before you, they used to take him, the government, the society, the majority, and they will dig a hole in the ground. and they will dump him in this hole. It's not the end of the story. And they will come with a saw, and they put it in the middle of his head, and they start to cut it him two pieces. Doesn't stop him. All this torture did not stop him to believe in Allah and to practice his deen. Somebody stood up and he said, stop the Muslims from coming. And some people got so scared. Two people, they did act of terrorism or act of violence in California, and now 14 people die. I did not order them to do this, neither you. They did not ask for fatwa to do this. We are not supporting what they're doing. Why we have to be fearing anybody? We did not support what people doing. Why are we going to hide? Why are we going to start stay at home that we could not come to Jum'ah? No. You need to be strong. Don't transgress. Don't do any injustice. Behave and be a Muslim. You should be proud to be a Muslim. It's time for more da'wah, because the non-Muslims want to know about those people that their future, so-called future president, want to keep them out of the country. But I know that the media is working very hard to paint your picture, to make a dark picture. The same time this terrorism was taking place in California, in Georgia was talking something else took place. But how much did you hear about this? The coverage of anything done by a Muslim doesn't matter, is he practice Islam or not? We're going to blow it up and make it a big scene to everybody. I would say, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this, and he telling us, by Allah, لا يتمن الله هذا الأمر. Allah will complete the mission of this Islam. And now Allah will perfect it, this deen. And one of you will travel from Sana'a to Hadramaut. Has no fear of anything other than Allah, and the wolf may attack his sheep. Fear is no big deal. Listen to the Quran, start to read the Quran. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا. Those who've been told that people had to prepare for you, they're going to come to get you. They hide in their houses, they stop making prayer, they shave their beard, they took their hijab off. Allah said, فزادهم إيمانا, increase their faith. Why? Because they believe لا إله إلا الله, that no one have power almighty other than Allah. Where is the tawheed? Where is the true iman? Where is the trust in Allah? Why you having a fear? Why? Why you so worried? My brothers and my sisters, we living in America, and we living in this life, and we know that we've been created by Allah, and Allah has set the goal and the means for us to be living wherever we are living. Allah made it clear, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Indeed, I have created mankind and jinn only for purpose of worshipping me alone. So this is our goal. Your degree is not the goal. It is something comes as number three, number four, whatever number you want to do it. Never ever put anything before Allah and the deen of Allah, because in your prayer you repeat it how many times every day? Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. In the adhan, Allahu Akbar. In the iqamah, Allahu Akbar. Entering in the salah, Allahu Akbar. Raising from ruku' and going to ruku', Allahu Akbar. Do you know what does Allahu Akbar mean? Do you believe that Allah is Akbar? So we have a one single goal as our priority. Not the dollar Akbar, not the shahada Akbar, not the degree Akbar, but Allahu Akbar. And this da'wah and this worship that we've been created for, ud'u ila sabili rabbika bil hikmah wal maw'izati al hasana. Invite them all to the way of your Lord with wisdom and good admonishment. So whatever means halal means that exists that you can do it, to propose the da'wah to the non-Muslims, you have to treat them in this way. Allah did not say and get them into Islam with a machine gun. He said da'wah, talk to them. And he said good admonishment. He said a good argument. He did not say beat them on the head. He did not say go and kill them. He did not say disturb them because they are different from you. We are here to be Abdullah and Amatullah. And we have to look to the American people. And we have to care for the American people. And all what we want to give them is the da'wah. If they took it, alhamdulillah. If they take it, alhamdulillah. If they did not take it, you got the blessing for the da'wah. How are we supposed to act in so-called difficult and hard time? Let's look first to the example of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What Allah said, فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعُ النَّفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ إِن لَمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَسَفًا. Perhaps, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you going to kill yourself out of grief and sadness over the kuffar, that because they don't believe. That the love of the Prophet, the caring of the Prophet, the patience of the Prophet disturb him so much that the people did not want to believe to such a degree. This sadness was almost take over and kill him, not to make him sick, like somebody say, I'm sick of this. No, the Prophet was so concerned that Allah said, Muhammad, are you killing yourself? Are you destroying your understanding? Take it easy. They believe what they're done to believe. فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُذَكِّرْ. This means the Prophet ﷺ has this big heart and this love for the non-Muslims for purpose of da'wah. He did not say, if they did not believe, you go and kill them. This is not. With the love and the concern of the Prophet ﷺ have to be our concern for those people. How are we supposed to act? About da'wah. Reminding the people, teaching the people, giving books and flyers to the people, talking to them about Islam. Have this caring for them. Same way like a doctor care for a patient, you have to be a doctor, but you are a doctor for the heart, not the body. You concern for them. This is the methodology, and this is one of your approach to the times that you're living in it, which you call it a time of fear and be scared to come out of your house. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in Surah Al-A'raf, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. خُذِ الْعَفْوَ, give forgiveness and command what is good, and turn away from the foolish one. If you hear a statement of a foolish person, you don't have to curse. You don't have to do anything. Show a good example. This is our methodology. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving us the methodology, how to deal with the non-Muslims. How when somebody make a stupid and dumb statement, how you supposed to act? He said, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ. This is what we selling and giving. This is our product, forgiveness. Let it go. And what? وأمر بالعرف, the معروف. There is a common thing among the people. They understand, especially American people, about equality, about freedom, about all the things. So remind them what their constitution is about. What is the American being built on, based on what? There is ma'ruf in our deen, and there is urf and ma'ruf. They themselves acknowledge it. Remind them. And when one of them act bad or make a wrong statement, Allah say, what? وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. Turn away from the jahilin. There is many jahilin. And if you go to follow every jahil, you don't have time to see your children. You don't have time to make salah. You don't have time. You're going to be busy. And even going to everybody with the camera and running to Islamic Center, the imam, representative. Every day there is a statement is coming, and it's going to be more statement. So what? This is another way, you understand, to take you away from what you're doing. Arid, let it go. Let it go. What's happened? Okay? What happened? Don't worry about it. Because you have a mission. Because you have a goal. Because paradise is waiting for you. Because you are here to promote the da'wah and the goodness and helping the people and caring for others. You don't have time, everybody curse and everybody say something bad. Now you're going to make a statement and sit and type and email and all this. We have something different. وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. I would like to remind myself with the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْقَاضِ مِنَ الْغَيْضِ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. What this Quran came for? The non-Muslims? It came for everybody. يَكُونَ لِلْعَالَمِينَ نَذِيرًا. For everybody. Past, present, and future. Muslims and non-Muslims. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, those who control their anger when they get angry. And what else? And those who forgive the people. Let it go. Let it go. Doesn't matter if it's a Muslim or non-Muslim. Doesn't matter if it's a brother or a sister. Let it go. Allah is al-afu, and He wants to see us carry this kind of characteristic of forgiveness and let it go. Don't keep, you understand, you remember such a day you said and such, and such a day you did such and such. خذ العف وأمر بالعرف وأعرض عن الجاهلين وَالْقَاضِ مِنَ الْغَيْضِ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. He said, النَّاسِ, he did not say even the Muslims. Nas is more general than believers. And those who forgive the people. And Allah loves those who have ihsan. He's back to you, you be good to Him. He deprive you, you give Him. He shout at you, you talk to Him nicely. This is called ihsan. This is a better treatment. When somebody be ugly, don't be ugly with him. Because what? Remember this, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah loves those who are good and excellent in their treatment, in their speech, in their giving. When somebody deprive you, you don't have to deprive him. You have the right to do the same. But are you concerned about the love of Allah? So let it go. قاضي من الغيث والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين. My dear respected brothers and sisters, it's not the time to hide. It's not the time to change your name. And inshallah, it's never going to be the time. Be firm, be strong, and remember, المؤمن القوي خير وأحب إلى الله من المؤمن الضعيف. A strong believer is more dearer to Allah and more loved by Allah than a weak one. The fear, إِنَّمَا ذَلِكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ يُخَوِّفُ أَوْلِيَاءَ فَلَا تَخَافُوا. Indeed, this is the shaitan putting fear in your hearts. Keep your headpiece on. Keep going to the mosque. Give your classes and show the people what Islam is about by your action before your words. Alhamdulillah. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. I remind myself as well my brothers and sisters in some of this cold difficult time. Maybe you call it difficult. If you see other people and other nations, other countries and people that have been refugees between mountains, you will know that you're living in paradise. Nevertheless, if you call it a hard time, listen what Allah is saying, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا لَقِيتُمْ فِئَةً فَاثْبُتُوا وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Oh, you believe, if you face with your enemy, you have a combat, you have a battlefield, Allah did not say sharp your knives. He said, be firm. Firmness is, this is the most important thing. And what comes after this? He said, wazkurullah. But he said, remember Allah, but it's not stop. He said, a lot. If you think you're going through some hardship and difficulty, be firm. Be firm. Inna Allah ma'al ladhina taqaw wal ladhina hum muhsinun. Allah with those who have taqwa, those who have ihsan. So it say be firm and remember Allah a lot. Not to understand before you go sleep, Bismik Allahumma amutu ahya, and they say the whole day music and running here and gossip. No. وَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. So we need in time of so-called hardship happening that we need to turn more to Allah and have more firmness and to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot. Also, I want to remind myself as well as all my brothers and sisters. وَأَطِعُوا اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ وَاصْبِرُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. It's time that we get together, be supportive for one another, and for us to show submission to Allah's order and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and do not have dispute among yourselves. All the things that breaks the community, the solidarity, the brotherhood, the sisterhood from different means and different ways. It's time to be more united. It's time to be together. It's time to revive our mosque and be there in the mosque. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَتَفْشَلُوا, you be defeated, you be a loser. Everybody have his own opinion, everybody have his own school, his own masjid, his own ideology, and everybody. No, get together, be together, be one. Yes, yeah, say everybody saying this, but Allah said, وَأَطِعُوا اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ, not your opinion, not your culture, not the Islam they practice in your country. وَأَطِعُوا اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ. Okay? Otherwise, we're going to be divided, and after this, we're going to be nothing except a failure. And say, and be patient. Be patient. Indeed, Allah with those who are patient. I close this with statement of those who have made some fear in their hearts. The hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he told Abdullah ibn Abbas, part of the hadith, وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةِ لَوْ اجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَكَ وَلَوْ اجْتَمَعُوا عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ. رفعت الأقلام وجفت الصحف. My brothers and sisters, we have a belief system that's greater than mountains and stronger and harder than iron. This is the aqidah. Be aware that if the whole nation get together to benefit you with something, they could not benefit you with anything other than what Allah had decreed for you. Only they're going to give you what been decreed by Allah for you. And if the whole mankind, not Colombia, not America, not China, if all mankind get together to harm you with anything in your exam, in your job, with your family, with your green card, with your migrant, whatever they want to attend and do for you. And be aware, if everybody get together to harm you with something, they could not harm you with anything other than what Allah had decreed upon you. The pen left it and the ink is dry. We believe in the Qadr of Allah. It's part of the system of belief. You could not be a true believer and you don't believe in the Qadr. It's been written. Don't worry. But I want to give you some glad tiding, if you don't mind. But before I give you the glad tiding, which one I should do first? Anyway, this is at least three emails that I selected. I'm not going to read all of them for you. But this one from Beth in Colombia. And she says that she's an elderly woman, 75 years old. I was born here in Colombia. I wanted to express my support of all of you in the Islamic Center. I am sorry about Trump and all that is going right now. And I just hope you will bear with us and try to be patient with us. American woman calling Islamic Center to apologize and to say be patient with us. This is somebody, like I said, وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ, turn away from the foolish. Okay? This is one example. This is another example. Please send me your address. I want to send you some donation for your mask during this crazy time. And this is David. Thank you very much. Okay. Like I said, we have many emails to see from American people. Men and women show their support and apologize to what Donald had said. So you are not here to focus in one man. Focus about the society, the whole people. It's not all American people is about what he said or what he planning or whatever it is. And always put your trust in Allah. Now we close with some announcement here. Number one, somebody sent an email, a Muslim brother. It says that the Imam claims that he following the sunnah, why he making ikama late? It's supposed to be 5 minutes for Maghrib and 10 minutes for the other salah. You should stick to the sunnah. I'm sorry, my brother, you don't know what the sunnah is talking about. The Prophet did not make 5 minutes and 10 minutes. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam means the ikama when he sees the people in, no people there, the Prophet will wait. Okay? But if you have evidence, show it to me and I will follow the sunnah. All right? Second announcement, we would like some volunteer. We have a table in the flea market. We bought Quran for free, copy of the Quran, flyers, book, Islam is. Once somebody stands there by the table, it's time for da'wah. When people hear all these things going on, they want to know more about Islam. But we have a table and nobody wants to stand there by the table. What? If somebody have a question, going to ask at the table? Come on. What we don't lose our time? Everybody busy, everybody busy. Who's going to carry the deen of Allah? You in America, you got the opportunity. But when crazy people asking you, get ready, get your machine gun, and come join us to fight America, people go. We are not asking you to do this. We talk later on about this is not Islamically. We're asking you a simple things. Educate the American people. Be there. Contribute to this country like you had received a lot of goods of this country. So we need some volunteer, inshallah. And the brother Ahmed is here, inshallah, if anybody willing to support this effort, even if it's few hours a week, few hours a month, it will make a difference. Number three, we still, after 10, 15 years, we're still going to make the same announcement. We still have a problem about people parking their car in front of others. And after this, after Jum'ah, they don't run back to the car, double parking and delay. One of the doctors, you understand, the patient wait in the clinic for 15 minutes waiting for somebody to come. Brothers, I'm sorry. I don't know really what I can do. All what I can tell you, please have a truck, company, phone, ready in your cell phone. You found somebody blocking your car, give it 3 minutes after the salah. If he's not there, call the tow truck. I'm giving you this right, and do it. Other than this, you're going to be sitting there for half an hour and 1 hour. Otherwise, I don't know. If you know better, advise me what we can do. I would like to remind you all, that we have care meeting tomorrow, Saturday, immediately after Salat al-Maghrib. We have many issues we need to discuss. We don't need the Imam and the Shura, as they said. We want to hear, what the community is about, what they're trying to do, what's what. There is a lot that we need to meet once a month. Once a month is not too much. Subhanallah. Stop playing games with your deen. People are suffering different places. We could not come once a month to sit down as Muslim and talk with each other. Guess what? One of the big official people here in Colombia, they want to come attend our meeting. And I apologize to them. I said, I'm sorry. We could not make it. But we can meet in private meeting. I don't want embarrassment. They want to come to see what is care meeting and try to extend their apology for what is happening and establish some relationship with the Muslim community. This is a big official person. Okay? But I said, because what? People do not, some of the, they don't have even the discipline how to sit in a gathering. And we're going to have what, 10, 15 people and some kids running and slamming doors? I say, I'm sorry, we can make another meeting which we can have some of the executive members can sit with you and we can discuss it. Start to do something. Let's do something for our families. Let's try to do something for the non-Muslims. Let's try to be together. Let's try to think about the mosque. Come and bring your complaint, bring your project, bring your ideas. Once a month is not too much, my brothers and sisters. Wallahi, we're supposed to be ashamed. The Christians they meet, the Jews they meet, every people they meet and discuss their problems, and they hear about ideas and all these things. And we begging you to come once a month. You're so busy, you don't have time for the mosque for 1 hour a month. May Allah help us all. This is all what I can say. So inshallah, my brothers, I hope I did not spoil your khutbah, but be firm, be strong, and put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's time for more da'wah. It's not the time to hide. It's time for us to be more in front of the people, to know about what Islam is about, have communication, have dialogue, giving them some books, try to talk to them about Islam. I beg Allah's forgiveness for me and you and all the Muslims, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help the Muslims everywhere, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help the non-Muslim to get to understand what the Muslims is about and what Islam is about. We ask that Allah gives them the guidance before they die. Ameen. Wa akhir da'wana and alhamdulillah rabbil alameen.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا واعتدلوا تراصوا stretch your line please get close to each other stretch your line please Everybody be concerned about straightening the line. Look to your right, look to your left, and make sure that the line is straight. Don't lap. Stow, اعتدلوا. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم
صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك؟ فإن مع العسر يسرا، إن مع العسر يسرا. فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد، ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Please, if you are double parking, go and move your car immediately.